Hello and welcome to the course CS348 Advanced Computer Network. We are in module 2. This is the fifth lecture of this module. If you remember, in the last lecture we have discussed the agent discovery. Before you continue watching this video, I recommend you should complete the previous video. If you are facing any difficulties in understanding this lecture, you are free to post queries in the comment section or during the live session on the Microsoft Teams. So let's begin. This is the syllabus of our module 2 and we are discussing mobile IP now. So in the lecture 3 we have discussed about IP packet delivery. In the last lecture, that is your lecture 4, we have discussed agent discovery, and this lecture is on discussing about the registration process. Okay, so before I am going to explain the registration process, let us first recall the agent discovery process. What will happen? Suppose you are the mobile network or mobile node, and you are present in home node, and at some point of time, let's say you move to a foreign network. Then how do you determine that you are in home network or foreign network? That will be done by two methods. We have discussed this in the last class. That is called the agent discovery process. So either a home agent or a foreign agent sends a registration package, that is called advertisement packet. So by seeing that advertisement packet, you will able to know whether you are in home network or in a foreign network. So after reaching to the foreign network, you will get an address. That address is called actually COA, or the care of address. The care of address is either maintained by the FA. When it is maintained by the FA, the foreign agent, the term COA is associated with it. But when the COA is actually maintained by you, that is called the co-located address. Okay. When COA is maintained by foreign agent, the tunnel is actually created from your home agent to the foreign agent. Any data for you received by your home agent will send the data through this tunnel to the foreign agent, and finally foreign agent will send the data to you in case of a COA. But if it is a co-located address, then your device will get a new address, then the tunnel is created from home agent to directly to you. So the data will be transferred through this tunnel, not using this tunnel. Fine. This is what we have discussed in the agent discovery process. Now let us understand what is the meaning of registration. So the meaning of registration means whenever you get a COA, care of address, or a co-located address, whatever that may be, whenever you get this address, then you need to tell your home agent that I am not in my home network, I am in this foreign network, and my new address is this. Whenever you get any packet for me, kindly send to this address. Okay, this is your responsibility. You have to tell, because you have already moved to the foreign network. So that process is called actually the registration. So let me read this 2 point. Whatever I have explained, that thing is written over here. Having received the COA, the MN has to register with the HA or the home agent. The main purpose of the registration is to inform the HA of the current location for correct forwarding of the packet. That means you need to specify that my current location is this address. You should forward the packet through this channel. Okay, that is the process of registration. The registration is done in two different ways. One is called COA is at FA. Second one is called COA is co-located. That means whenever you get an address or new address, or you will be identified by an address, a new address, that is either maintained by you. When it is maintained by you, that is called co-located address. When that address is maintained by your foreign agent, that is called care of address. So based upon these two addresses, there are two ways to register yourself with the home agent. So let us move forward. Now see the scenario. In this scenario, what happened? You have already moved from your home network to the foreign network, and you get a COA. The first case, represent the COA is at FA. That means COA is maintained by your FA, or we can say the foreign agent knows your address, which is nothing but a COA, let us say. Okay, so you know that you have already been getting a COA. You have already get a COA which will be used for data transmission. Now your home agent need to know this COA, because whenever your friend sends a data, this should be resend to the COA, means through the COA. So that's why you send a registration request packet. So one packet you will send, that is called registration request packet, let's say RRP, to your foreign agent. This is shown here. You are the mobile node, you send a registration request packet to your foreign agent. Now the foreign agent, what is the work of foreign agent? The foreign agent will send that registration packet to the home agent. So this will be sent to your home agent, this RRP, or this is called registration request packet. Now after the registration request packet is received by your home agent, he will do the mobility binding. So what happened in mobility binding? Mobility binding containing the mobile node's home IP address and the current COA. You assume that, let's say this your home agent will maintain a table like this. Because this is a router, he has to maintain a table. So what the table will contain? It will contain something like this. It will contain the actual IP address. Okay, previously, whenever you are here, you get a IP. That IP will be represented here. Then your COA, that is the care of address, and the last one is called the lifetime. Means for how much time you are in this address, that is required. Okay. So what is the concept of mobility binding? The mobility binding contains the lifetime of the registration. As I have already told you, this contains the lifetime of the means how much time you are there in the process, and the registration automatically expires after the lifetime is over. Okay, then after mobility binding is over, the home agent will reply with a registration reply message. Okay, and this is your registration request. Then another message will send by your home agent to the foreign agent. That message is called actually a registration reply message. This registration reply message is again sent to the mobile node. Registration reply message. After you get the registration reply, you now be assured that your new address is known to your home agent. The further communication will be taken place by the help of your COA. Okay, this is the first case where COA is actually represents your foreign agent. But if you get a co-located address, in the second scenario, if you get a co-located address, then this co-located address is now act as a COA for you. And that time, it is very much easy to register yourself. There will be no need to send this that registration request message to your foreign agent. You can directly send this message. That is the second scenario. COA is co-located. Then you can directly send your co-located address to the home agent. So this RRP, registration request message, okay, a registration request packet will be directly sent to your home agent. After the registration request packet will be received by your home agent, he will again do the mobility binding by maintaining this kind of table over there. After that, he will reply. So a reply message will come to you directly. Now you will get assured that your new co-located address is known to your home agent. Okay, so whenever your friend or your anybody who sends a packet to you with this IP, then the home agent will immediately send that particular packet to the care of address and you will get that message. Fine, makes sense. I think you understand the process how the registration will be done. So this is the only two way how the registration is done. Now the next part in this lecture we are going to discuss is how the message packet looks like, means what the request packet and the reply packet. What are the different fields are present in request and registration reply package. So let's go for the next slide. This is your this is how the registration request packet looks like. This is a 32-bit address. Let us discuss one by one. So the type is set to 1 for a registration request. Whenever you are sending a registration request, the type must be 1. Remember, these are UDP packets. These are UDP packets which are used for your registration request. So the type field will be set to 1. Then these are the 1-bit fields. These are 8-bit, all are 1-bit field. What is the meaning of these bits? Let us see. With the S bit, an MN can specify if it wants the HA to return prior mobility binding. So you have already maintained a mobility binding concept. I have already discussed. So that means your COA is represented here and there will be a lifetime and you are having a IP, actual IP of yours. So now if the S bit is set to 1, you are trying to say your home agent that kindly keep the COA as it is. Don't change the COA now. I mean the same network currently. Okay, so S bit means it retains the prior mobility binding. Whatever you have done previously, make it there. Don't change anything, even if the lifetime expires. Okay. Second bit is called B bit. Setting the B bit generally indicates that the MN, an MN also wants to receive a broadcast packet which have been received by the home agent in the home network. Means what will happen? You know that either it will be a home agent or a foreign agent, both are sending broadcast message to their network. This is discussed in the last lecture. So these broadcast message which are sent to the home network, if you want that broadcast message should come to you also, then you set this B bit to 1. Then whenever the home agent sends the broadcast message to the home network, along with that he will send that broadcast message to you also. So that indicates the B bit. The next point is, if an MN uses a co-located COA, as I have already discussed, either you get a co-located address or you will get a COA which is maintained by your foreign agent. If MN are co-located COA, it also take care of the decapsulation at the tunnel point. So if you get a co-located address, then the decapsulation process is maintained by you only. So this field indicates that, right? The next is M and G. We have already discussed in the last class, and M and G, M represents the minimal encapsulation and generic routing encapsulation. And also we have discussed about T, that is called that indicates the reverse tunneling, and it is also this M, G, T will be also discussed in the next class too, in the tunneling and encapsulation process. This R and X field set to 0 for a registration request message. Next, so the next part is called all these fields are over. Now let us come to the lifetime. As I have already discussed, lifetime specifies how many times the care of address is valid. So lifetime denotes the validity of the registration in second, how much time it will be valid. If you set it to 0, indicates you want to deregister that address. If all bits set means all bit are 1, then it indicates infinity. Means infinitely you will be there. Fine. Then the next is the home address. Obviously the home address is the fixed IP address of your MN, means your home IP. Then your home agent is the IP address of your HA. Then COA represents the tunnel endpoint. That means if it is maintained by your FA, the tunnel will go to this place. If it is a co-located address, the tunnel will start from HA and goes to the MN. Okay, this is the tunneling concept. Then identification message, this is 64-bit, is generated by MN to identify request and match it with the registration reply. So to identify whether you are belongs to this or not, so both should be matched together. Then some extension is needed for security purpose. So extension must at least contain parameters for authentication. So some parameter will be sent through this message for authentication purposes. Okay, this is all about your registration request packet. So after the registration request packet, a reply message will also came from your home agent. So what is that? Let us read about those field. So this the registration reply packet look like this. This is also a UDP packet, and whenever you are replying the message, then the type field is set to 3. So here the type field is set to 3. When you send a request package, the type field is set to 1. That is the only difference. What do you mean by this code? Code indicate the result of the registration request. So when you send, suppose you send a registration request to your home agent. This is your registration request. RRP, registration request packet. This is your registration request packet. And when after receiving this packet, is it means always true that you will get a reply, correct reply from it? Even if you get a reply, he will specify some code in this field. So there are different code which indicate a different meaning. So first of all, let us see what are the different code available there. So when the code is 0, registration is accepted. But when the code is 1, registration accepted, but simultaneous mobility binding unsupported. Okay, so registration will be accepted, but and other codes you can read from here. 65, administratively prohibited. 66, insufficient resources. 67, mobile node failed authentication. 68, home agent failed authentication. 69, request lifetime too long. So these are the code replied by your reply message. So depending upon those value, the MN will able to know whether he is successfully registered with your home agent or not. Fine. So lifetime, it is already there. The lifetime field indicates how many seconds the registration is valid, that we have already discussed. Home address, you know, home address indicate home address and home agent. This is your IP address or the MN's IP address. Home agent means the home agent's IP address. Identification is also the same thing, that is 64-bit, and extension is used for your authentication purpose. Okay, so this is the reply message sent by your home agent to you. This is how registration takes place. I hope this is end of the lecture. Thank you for listening, and that's all.